first I want to start off by, you know, telling you that you've been such a survivor. You know, people say, ha, celebrity hai. Of course, she has all the resources. She has the money. You know, people know. And, you know, a lot of those things, right? But tell me, how difficult was it for you to even, you know, actually map the journey of being a survivor?
Well, you know, a couple of things which comes in my mind. First of all, when a disease happens, it doesn't segregate that it should come only to the privileged or non-privileged or people who are celebrity or non-celebrity. At the end of the day, we all are human beings and we all bleed. And we all have the same kind of pain and anguish, you know. But having said that, I do understand that people do feel that we are privileged and we have an access, which is true also. I had an access to get myself treated and to get enough right information. I feel blessed and I'm in gratitude for that. But nevertheless, my struggle was not easy. You know, it was not less painful because of that. You know, it's been hugely painful. Something that really shook me out of my comfort zone. Completely shook me and my family. I feel comments like that, it really hurts me when people just casually mention something like that and put me in a category like that, as if I'm not a human being. It's been most painful journey for me.
Okay. And why did you, I mean, think of penning your journey, you know, into a book?
Well, I feel it was such a huge aspect of my life. It's been 6 years and my whole concept about life, my whole perception on life changed, and realizing that I could die one day and realizing that probably it'll be sooner than later, there was a huge shift in my experiencing life. And I felt compelled to tell the story. I felt compelled to tell people that, you know, the way I took my life and my health for granted, please don't do that. And so I guess I felt compelled to write a book, to actually memorize everything so that I never forget that. Also, I feel by telling people the kind of trauma a cancer patient goes through, probably people can understand other cancer patients and be of some use and, you know, whatever. And see, people who probably will never be touched with cancer, and the family members will never be touched with any health diseases or whatever, to really be grateful, to really enjoy this life and to be focused about leading a healthy life and fulfilled life, you know, because everything is intertwined and interconnected. So multiple reasons I wrote this book.
Okay. Wasn't it difficult? Because we always think that I don't want to remember that particular thing, you know, the pain that I went through. Whatever it is, whatever, even for a small thing, if you get a cut on a finger also, we're like, no, I don't want to relive those, that memory. So how challenging and how difficult was it as a process for you to think and then put your pen to paper?
It was very challenging. It was very difficult. And one whole year of going and talking and writing, and I made many drafts of the book. So multiple drafts of the same thing. So imagine, you know, putting 10 hours, 12 hours in a day. So it was very tough for me. But I feel if something has happened, as painful as that, but it has helped you to evolve, to grow, to become a better human being. You know, so I feel such stories should be told, no matter how painful it is. But it also was a transformative process. So it was really useful for me. And since it was useful for me, I wanted to share with the world.
A lot of, you know, family and friends in industry, you know, people also stood by you, you know, and that is, I think, you actually identify who are your true friends when they stand by you in, you know, in need. So what do you have to say about that?
Well, whoever stood by me, I really am grateful for that. And times of trouble, which is being said before, actually makes you recognize your people who are there for you through thick and thin, and who are not. And I'm grateful for both people who stood by me and people who didn't. That people who didn't actually taught me something really important, that even I was like that. Even I used to shy away from being in the presence of somebody else's pain and sorrow. So I used to also evade being in that. I used to just escape going to that. So it has helped me to become a better person, realizing that.
Okay. Also, we saw you in Love Stories. And like I told you, that spark in you is just, I mean, it remains. I cannot forget that, you know, the beach scene when you're running and coming and asking, how do I look? And he says, you look like a mother of two. And you're like, oh, really? Me and my mother of two? Not at all. You know, you really didn't look like that, you know. So, would we see you in more web series? Is there any film, any productions that are coming up?
Absolutely. There are a few scripts which I have located. And in 2019, we'll be filming that. So, finger crossed, they all turn out to be good, hopefully. Because I say no to most of the script that comes my way. So, whichever I say yes, I just hope it turns out to be a good one.
Even Sanju, where you played the mother, right? And a lot of, I think, actresses kind of are reluctant to do that, you know. They say, no, once I'm a lead actor, that's what I'll always play. But why did you take up Sanju, and how was that experience to actually play a mother, you know?
Well, honestly speaking, I loved working in Sanju. Because the whole environment, everybody was so positive, so focused, so doing good work and good human beings, good people. So I enjoyed working in that film, and I'm glad I took that on. And you know, there's when once you're a leading actress, and to get on to a character role, it is tough. I have to be honest, and I have to tell you guys that it's not easy, you know. But that's what life is, you know. No matter how tough it is, no matter how painful it gets sometimes, when you're the center of attention, and sometimes you're not. But that's how life is.
And mashallah, you're looking so nice and so gorgeous. So, what is it that you are doing for fitness now? Because you've also recovered and you're looking like stunning, you know. So, what is your fitness mantra? And
well, basically now I'm planning to go to Everest Base Camp. And so, it needs me to really train every day. And so, I have a trainer and I train. Plus, I do yoga, pranayam. And try to lead a very healthy lifestyle, enough sleep, eating correct, and all that. But I guess more than that, at the bottom of it, behind everything, all that is just love for life and love to grab every opportunity that life throws at me.
Also, taking a cue from Love Stories, is there any relationship advice you would like to give to people today?
I don't think I can give any relationship advice to anyone. I can only say one thing: love yourself, you know, honor yourself, and give priority to yourself. You know, look after your first responsibilities towards yourself. Relationship can happen or doesn't happen, it doesn't matter.